Why moon, first of all? What is leprosy? Can someone explain me? I don't know what is leprosy. Explain it to me. How is leprosy caused?
Skin issue, skin discoloration.
An infectious disease that damages the skin and nervous system. Very rare. Treatment from medical professional advice often requires lab test imaging. Leprosy, also known as Hansen's disease, is a long-term infection by the bacteria Mycobacterium leprae or Microbacterium leprosomatosis. Infection can lead to damage of the nerves, respiratory tract, skin, and eyes. This nerve damage may result in a lack of ability to feel pain, which can lead to the loss of parts of person's extremities from repeated injuries or infection due to unnoticed wounds. Why moon? Read the last line.
Feelings. He has to feel.
Loss of feelings. Of sensory nerves or anything. Got the coin? Got the point? Got the point or not? That's why moon. Okay. Moon. In the signs of Pisces, Cancer, Capricorn, Aries. What these signs have to do with disease, first of all? It is a moon-based disease. Okay, you understand this. It is a moon-based disease. That's why moon is taken into consideration. That is very okay. But how are these four signs connected to the disease, first of all? Tell me this. How to find the sign? How to find signs which will give disease, which will give disease related to signification of the planet. How to find it? You have read Rashi, come on. Come on.
Placement of debilitation sign from the Rashi.
Right. Brilliant. Abhilasha ji have understood the basics of science very clearly. I gave you an example of why Mercury in Cancer gives a lot of money or not. Try to understand something, my friend. Try to understand something. Suppose. I will take the science as one by one. Ye cancer ka ek gola nahi hat raha hai, warna batata hu. Suppose this is cancer. Where is moon debilitated? If this is cancer 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Moon is debilitated in 5th house. The blessing of debilitation will come. Is it good? No. If it is Pisces, once again, blessing of debilitation will come. Is it good? No. If it is Capricorn, there is income of debilitation or gains of debilitation. Is it good? No. If it is Aries, there is a death because of debilitation. Is it good? Okay. Basic rule. This is only applicable in design. This is only applicable in design. Corona is a disease of respiratory organ. Which planet indicates respiratory organ? One. गलती करने से घबराए नहीं, कर दे.
मर्करी,
सैटर्न,
सैटर्न.
भाई वायु, वायु का कारक सैटर्न होता है ना, सांस
लेने में. सैटर्न, बट सर सांस में जब प्रॉब्लम होती है तो मर्करी भी लेते हैं ना.
इन वो मर्करी को किस तत्व से सांस पकड़ेंगे वो नहीं समझ पाया मैं. हाँ, अर्थ एलिमेंट गंध जरूर रूल करता है, बट हवा, वायु, वात तो शनि को लेना चाहिए. और ऑल्सो जल्दी नहीं मर रहा ना आदमी भाई, कोरोना से आराम से मरेगा. आज होगा, एक हफ्ते तड़पोगे, फिर मरोगे, काइंड ऑफ होगा. तो भाई, हाँ जी, नन प्लीज 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 से
सर. फॉर मर्करी पर्टिकुलरली अस्थमा इज टेकन मे बी बिकॉज इट्स गेट एक्टिवेटेड विद परफ्यूम्स एक्सेट्रा. जनरली अस्थमा डस्ट एंड परफ्यूम, सो मर्करी डिनोट्स अस्थमा, बट जनरल डिजीज ऑफ लंग्स इज टेकन बाय सैटर्न. That's what I've read.
Yeah. Saturn in which Navamsha should give you disease, 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 disease. To find it, there is a very simple rule. Trine principle, 11th principle, and 8th principle. This is the basic rule that we got from the shloka, right? Basic rule from the shloka. Basic rule from a shloka. Trine to Sagittarius and Aries. Sorry, Sagittarius and Leo. When Saturn is debilitated in Aries, that is in trine to Sagittarius and Leo. That is in 11th from Gemini. And that is in 8th from Virgo. It's from Virgo or not? It's from Virgo.
Yes.
So Saturn in Sagittarius, Leo, Gemini, Virgo, Navamsha should give you disease. Oh, here the Saturn is saved by the Corona patient one. Saturn with Mars, not related to these signs, neither in Virgo, nor in Leo, nor in Sagittarius, neither in Gemini. Corona patient survived. Pinaki ji, Saturn in Namshan Pisces. No sign out of this sign. Now he is very hale and healthy. You remember in the Dasha course we did his chart? His wife. Saturn in Navamsha is in Leo. It was problematic. But in Dashantra, Saturn was not there. Valla. Saved. His daughter. Saturn. Once again, not in the signs mentioned above. No problem at all. Now. Oh shit, I was looking at a wrong chart all the way together. Sorry. I must have seen that D9, I looked at D3. Sorry. That's my mistake. If the examples are wrong, just correct it by yourself. Right. I will illustrate it using different rule. Mahatma Gandhi, how he died, you people know or not? What is the principle by? Come on, repeat the principle and how I can use it to find the reason of death for a person.
Tenth house.
The debilitation sign of the planet should come in 5, 9, 11 or 8. Right? I will check every planet and see if the debilitation of that planet. I will check every planet and see if the debilitation sign of the planet comes into 5, 9, 11 or 8. Let me do the exercise. Saturn's debilitation sign in
fifth house.
Saturn done. Jupiter's debilitation sign in second house, not applicable. Mercury debilitation sign in third, not applicable. Moon's debilitation sign in fifth, applicable. Sun's debilitation sign in sixth, not applicable. Venus debilitation sign in 11th, applicable. Mars debilitation sign in third, not applicable. Saturn plus Moon plus Venus should indicate the reason of death. He was with two women. He was killed because of an emotional grudge. And of course, Saturn indicates iron. Shot by bullet. Right? Not. But generally, a solution for disease, actually. The rule is applicable for disease. And the disease of Venus, loss of vitality is what happened. The goli mari aapke sharir se vitality nikalne lagi na. Loss of vitality is how he died. How he died. It is not finding the reason of death. It is finding that disease of, or which deficiency etc. caused death. It is just to find that. Is the rule very clear or not clear?
Yes, sir. Moon can also be taken as blood cells.
Sorry?
Moon can also be taken for blood cells.
What did you say?
Moon can also be taken for blood cells.
Yeah. Moon can also be taken for blood cells. Yeah, you're right. With Saturn and Mars, why? Come on. Patapat. Why conjunction with Saturn and Mars? Mars is lord of debilitation sign. Right? And Saturn is lord of exaltation sign of
Mars.
Planet who makes him debilitated. What is the combination of skin disease? What is skin disease? What is the combination of skin disease? Mercury in Navamsha with either Jupiter or Moon. Do you know anyone with a skin disease? No.
In D1, I know, but not that much big disease, small.
So D1 mein to small hi rahega karke D9 mein hoga to aayega macha. Ye jo jaan leva anand hai to D9 mein hi hai. Sadistic pleasure D9. What is the funda clear? I am giving you one after another shlokas for disease, right? Or not? Serious. Be serious about astrology. Now we are. For disease, I will tell you four acception. Can you guess my first acception? Pushkar. There is something known as Pushkar Amsha. Do you know? No. Pushkar Amsha is given in Jatak Parijat. Just go to Jagannath Hora, right click here. Pushkar Amsha and Pushkar Bhaga. Click here. You see how many planets? Sun, Pushkar Amsha, Mars, Pushkar Amsha, Jupiter, Pushkar Amsha, Venus, Pushkar Amsha. Oh my God. Planet in Pushkar Amsha. You will never get the disease of the planet. Okay? Even if you get the disease, you will be saved. Right? Even if you get the disease, you will be saved. That is my first exception. What is the second exception? You know, it was conjoined with the debilitation lord. Right? Or conjoined with the dispositor of the debilitation lord, conjoined with the exaltation lord, or conjoined with the dispositor of exaltation lord. So, moon with Mars or Saturn can give you disease. The same moon with Venus and Jupiter cannot give you disease. Because Venus, moon is exalted in Taurus and Venus is exalted in Pisces. Got my point very clearly? Got it? What is the third rule for reception? Debilitation sign in 5, 9, 11 and 8 gave the disease. If these signs are exaltation, then there will be no disease. What does it mean to say? Suppose in a chart there is a moon plus Mars. then it is probable for leprosy. But say this combination is happening in cancer, then the exaltation sign is in 11th, which is given here. So it is not a lifetime. The person will get cured from it. Or suppose the moon or Mars combination is happening in Virgo or is happening in Capricorn. Virgo, no disease. In Capricorn, because Capricorn is featured here, disease but recovery will also be there. What is my point very clearly? And what is the fifth rule? The planet being powerful and benefic. Powerful and benefic, what do I mean by that? Exalted. Vargottam. Aspected by benefic. Etc. etc. These are the four exceptions that you have to take into consideration. Got it? Or two more exceptions. Sixth Lord powerful. But weaker than Lagna Lord. Keeps a person disease free for a lifetime. Saturn not afflicted, no affliction at all. Keeps a planet disease free. For example, keeps a person disease free. For example, in my chart, the sixth Lord moon is in the sixth house. Sixth Lord is powerful. Powerful sixth Lord should give me disease. But Lagna Lord is also in own Rashi. It is not aspected by any planet. Plus it is in Pushkar. Getting my point? Disease free, tension free. Pushkar also gives you a lot of vitality, virility. I made a prediction for a lady, you know. For this lady, see her Pushkaramsha. Jupiter, yes. Ketu, yes. Mandi, yes. Lagna, yes. Lagna in Pushkaramsha. Any serious disease? Lagna itself is saved. Right? छोटा मोटा थोड़ा नाक में खरोच लगती है, ऐसा हो जाता है, उससे तो कोई नहीं बच सकता ना भाई। थोड़े मोटे उतार चढ़ाव तो जीवन में आती है, वरना जीवन ही क्या। Got it?
So what is the difference if a planet is in Pushkaramsha in a house?
There is a difference of traits between them. Right? Mercury should indicate intelligence. Fifth house would indicate, sun will indicate stomach. Fifth house can only indicate stomach. There is no planet who will indicate stomach, right? Houses are body parts. Planets are activities of body. That's the difference. Stomach is fifth house. Sun is only bones. That's the difference. There is no house which indicates bone. Right. So that categorization difference is there, just right. First house indicates head. Moon indicates migraine. Getting out? Body part. So the things that the rule is different, right? There is no house, no blood which will rule chest. Technically, for corona, I should see affliction of fourth house rather than looking at Saturn. The Saturn is why the Tumur, but still leave that part for now. Very clear, very good. You are intelligent students. What is Navamsh? Come on, give me one word answer that will make me happy.
Food.
Sorry? Sound is
playing. Your karma phala.
Yes. Is in Capricorn. While the moon is in Capricorn, the fifth house from it, respectively Taurus and Virgo, the Lagna. Taurus, Cancer, Scorpio. Is aspected by, aspected or conjoined, you also take. By malefic. Then, okka result. Then the result happens for sure. What is the specialty in this room? Speciality is first of all the rule of Lagna. Ascendant, which indicates, ascendant indicates what? What comes to native? You know what? Yeah, intelligence, yeah, that is true. What comes to native is indicated by Lagna. I always ask a question. This was my first question. Which I teach in Dasha. First question which I teach in Dasha, always. Lata Mangeshkar is a very good singer. She sang her first song that was super hit. And even at the in her 80s, she is successful. Which Dasha she is having for 80 years? Do you know of any Dasha which runs for 80 years? No. Why she is having such a result? Ascendant. Anything related to ascendant is permanent. What? Anything related to ascendant is permanent. That will happen anytime with or without your wish. Got it? Anything related to ascendant is yoked to the native. What anything related to the ascendant is yoked to you. Is a part and parcel of your personality. Anything related to the ascendant is permanent. And trine. You know what trine? Trine is blood. Trine is blood. By fifth house's father, Lagna is you. Sorry, ninth house's father, Lagna is you, fifth house's child. And all three of you have same blood group. If ninth house is fire sign, Lagna is also fire sign, and fifth house is also fire sign. What do I mean by same blood group? Is same element. So once the moon is in Capricorn, which is a possible disease sign, and Lagna is in trine to this sign, the disease is inherent. Disease is what? Inherent. the possibility of disease is inherent in blood. Got it? The possibility of disease is inherent in blood. Now, if the sign Taurus, exaltation, if the sign Cancer, own Rashi, or if the sign Scorpio, debilitation, of moon is having a malefic influence, then there is no escape for moon. Then there is no escape for moon. Got it very clear or not? No escape to moon. Got it? For any sure shot combination. Ask me something. Eczema. I had a chart with this disease. I don't know if I have that chart or not. I technically don't have that chart. Eczema. How is eczema caused, by the way? It should be caused from Mercury. Which house will give a probable Mercury disease? Mercury is debilitated in Pisces, so Cancer, Scorpio, and Taurus. So from Taurus, Pisces will be 11th, and Libra, from where Pisces will be. Not Libra. Leo, from where Pisces will be the 6th. These signs, the debilitation of the Mercury will come in from Cancer 9, from Scorpio 5, from Taurus 11, from Leo 8. These signs are supposed to give eczema if Mercury is in these signs. Okay. Now, if the trinal signs mean what? If Cancer, Scorpio, Taurus is trinal sign, Virgo, Capricorn, Leo trinal sign, Sagittarius, and Aries. If these signs, along with Mercury being in these signs in D9, if these signs are ascendant in D1, and at the same time Virgo own Rashi, Gemini own Rashi, and Pisces the debilitation Rashi is having malefic influence, then eczema for cure. Can you make the rules now? Can you use this rule for any planet? Okay, let me do something for you. Disease day. Why? Give me a simple straightforward answer. Which planet should indicate death from cancer?
Rahu.
Okay. Where Rahu?
Rahu and Ketu matlab ki केतु एकदम ऐसा दिखता नहीं है ना, कैंसर का कुछ पता ही नहीं होता, बाद में ही अचानक आ जाता है।
देखो भाई, समझो एक बात को, अपने की बात को समझिए।
केतु
वाई केतु वाई केतु
स्कॉर्पियो का रूलर है ना सर केतु, और सारी चीजें मतलब जैसे 8th हाउस के अंदर जो होती है इन द डार्क, तो कैंसर भी ऐसा ही है।
मार्स राहु एंड सैटर्न
सर, कैंसर सेल्स बढ़ते हैं, कम मतलब कम होते हैं फिर से बढ़ते हैं, disease and Ketu stay hidden for starting and at the end we come to know there is some disease.
According to me, the karaka for cancer is moon. Reason I will explain, but I have a research. Gemini says Capricorn indicates all type of pida. I have a rule. Capricorn in D9 having malefics more than 2, sure shot cancer. Write this rule very clearly. If not, no cancer at all. I had a client from Ukraine. Her daughter got diagnosed with cancer. She told me, sir, my daughter is diagnosed with cancer. I looked at the horoscope, there was no planet in Capricorn D9. I told your daughter is not having cancer. She sent me the doctor's slip and diagnosis. I told her, get it checked again. She said some miracle happened. They said it was a wrong diagnosis, she is not having any traits of cancer. Capricorn, more than one malefic in D9. Sure shot cancer, otherwise forget the chance of cancer at all. That's some other disease. Is my rule. But if I have to take a planet, I will take moon. Reason? Cancer is a self-sustaining disease. The cells of cancer sustain by themselves, or not? You know what moon indicates? Nutrition. माँ का प्यार, that's what cancer lives upon, nutrition. Okay, so now my friend, So, which signs are probable to give cancer? The signs from where the debilitation of moon comes in. Oh my God. The signs are already given there. Sir, Capricorn, Aries, Pisces, Cancer, Capricorn, Aries. The moon is in Aries in D9. That is the done. Now the trine from Pisces is Cancer, Scorpio. Trine from Cancer is also Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces added. Trine from Capricorn is Virgo and Capricorn. And trine from Aries is Leo and Sagittarius. Anyone of them being the ascendant? No. That's okay. But the exaltation sign of moon, Taurus, own sign of moon, Cancer, debilitation sign of moon, Scorpio, should have malefic influence. Is it so? Taurus having Rahu, Scorpio having Ketu, Cancer having the aspect of Mars and the aspect of Saturn. So we understand. So we understand the principle. What do we understand? These signs being the, yaar rang choose karo kya chal raha hai. These signs being the ascendant is not compulsory. But the malefic influence on these signs is essential. Check the horoscope of Sriman Ramana Maharshi. Check the horoscope of Sriman Ramana Maharshi. He also died because of cancer, but a spiritual person, so no bad karma. Okay, moon in Navamsha is in which Rashi? Gemini. Oh. The debilitation of moon comes in 8th from it. Probable diseases related to moon. The sign in the ascendant is Virgo. The sign in the ascendant is Virgo, Virgo. In Virgo, the ascendant principle is not matching. Right, but the important principle, affliction to Taurus, affliction to Cancer, affliction to Scorpio, along with moon in Navamsha, in a sign from where Scorpio, the debilitation of moon is in Kona or bad house. So Taurus is having Saturn aspect. Cancer is having Mars aspect. Plus Gulik Mandi. And Scorpio is having Mars aspect plus it is also 12th to Rahu. Are the three signs afflicted or not? Are the three signs afflicted or not? Yes. The prime rule for disease, you should take the exaltation, the debilitation, and the Mula Trigona sign of a planet. Afflicted gives you the disease.
Here, sir, we need ascendant has to be Libra or Aquarius, right? 5-9 to Gemini.
Sorry? Ascendant have to be Libra?
Aquarius, 5-9 to Gemini.
That is just to illustrate a thing technically.
No.
But your point is right. Your point is right.
Miss, because of that, it is not, as you said, no, ascendant is not.
I said ascendant principle is not applicable and should not be given much importance, right? Because, you know, I cannot say that only two ascendant people will have a disease. Got it clear? But what was the Subha Malok definite principle for Cancer? Capricorn having Mercury. Is Mercury a malefic? No. Mercury should be taken as a benefic because he is alone in the chart. But Capricorn is under the aspect of Mars. Under the aspect of Saturn, two malefic, Cancer.